front, the ground is actually dead. But it's actually stopped dead, you know, it won't be able to help. So if you walk towards the mirror and you see that actually his bum is there, regardless of where you are on the track or not, just move the shoulders in front. Right? So as he was there, he had quarters to the left, he was a bit on the shoulder, so what you would need to do is almost think, okay, I'm going to be on this side track, but I'm going to move the shoulders to the left. So that you put the shoulders in front of the engine, effectively. Right? So that's the one thing. For now, let's go this far. Don't worry about the outline. So wide with the soft hand and just think of obviously him going forward. Now what we need to work on is work on the action and him staying in front of you, as you said, which is right. The problem is also when you're in trot, you go too fast. Yeah. And so, and it's a very common mistake. You know, we think, oh my gosh, my horse is not going anywhere, kick, kick, kick. And it's exactly as I said to kick, the more they start going, I don't want to go because I'm being pushed out of balance and therefore I can't cope. And it becomes a vicious circle. The more you kick and the more the horse feels is out of balance, the more he'll come back, and then therefore the more he'll come back and the real problem. Regardless of where you are on the track or not, just move the shoulders in front. Right? So as he was there, he had quarters to the left, he was a bit on the shoulder, so what you would need to do is almost think, okay, I'm going to be on this side track, but I'm going to move the shoulders to the left. So that you put the shoulders in front of the engine, effectively. Right? So that's the one thing. For now, let's go this far. Don't worry about the outline. So wide with the soft hand and just think of obviously him going forward. Now what we need to work on is work on the action and him staying in front of you, as you said, which is right. The problem is also when you're in trot, you go too fast. Yeah. And so, and it's a very common mistake. You know, we think, oh my gosh, my horse is not going anywhere, kick, kick, kick. And it's exactly as I said to kick, the more they'll start going, I don't want to go because I'm being pushed out of balance and therefore I can't cope. And it becomes a vicious circle. The more you kick and the more the horse feels is out of balance, the more he'll come back, and then therefore the more he'll come back and the real problem. Right? And you won't be sure to do this way. So actually if your hand this rein goes there, you won't be able to move the shoulders. Right? So what I wanted to do is to actually move the shoulders that way. Okay, so your whole, you know, your upper body turned, then your arm turned, and if you pull towards me, then your inside leg stops it from coming towards me. So you're almost slightly kind of a leg heel, leg shoulders towards me, he's coming towards me, so left leg on, push him back onto the outside circle, and your left hand needs to come towards me. Better, you have to pull to the outside. So when you're on the circle, think that the shoulders actually turn first. Then we can always start controlling the quarters better. Okay, so think of the line of the circle that you're going to have. You're going to follow this line, always thinking that actually the shoulders come first. And just turn the front, right? And you want the shoulders to come this way. So actually if your hand this rein goes there, you won't be able to move the shoulders this way. Right? So what I want you to do is to actually move the shoulders that way. Okay, so your whole, you know, your upper body turned, then your arm turned, and if you fall towards me, then your inside leg stops him from coming towards me. So you're almost slightly kind of a little leg here, his leg shoulders towards me, like that. He's coming towards me, so leg, left leg on, push him back onto the outside circle, and your left hand needs to come towards me. Okay, that's better. You have to pull him forward to the outside. So when you're on the circle, think that the shoulders actually turn first. Then we can always start controlling the quarters better. Okay, so think of the line of the circle that you're going to have. So you're going to follow this line, always thinking that actually the shoulders come first. The quarters coming in here. Feel that? So you need to sit and just turn the front. Then you're kicking a lot. When if he doesn't react, give him a smack with a stick and then leave him quiet. Okay, that's better. Yep. And the outside rein more against the withers. Outside rein is to push the front towards me. That's it, yes. Ride him like that, now throwing the shoulder forward, the shoulder in position. Yeah? That's better. Try to keep that position on the bigger circle. There.
I don't know if you heard, Andy,
that's
I went.
It.
Andy.
Then you're kicking a lot. If he doesn't react, give him a smack with a stick and then leave him quiet.
I don't know if you heard, Andy,
that's
I went.
It.
Andy?
That's better. Now yield him back out to the big circle. Again, turn the front towards me, yield him away from your left leg.
Mm-hmm.
That's better. Now yield him back out to the big circle. Thank you. towards me, yielding away from your left leg. He's clearly at the moment more comfortable and he's actually slightly second to right.
Keep him straight.
So for a little while, I'll keep him leg right, give it the yard to left.
I'm struggling to record him.
Have I done it? I don't know if I'm Christian, but he can't have everything, can he?
Can you hurry up and stop rattling? I'm struggling to record him.
Have I done it? I don't know if I'm Christian, but he can't have everything, can he?
Can you hurry up and stop rattling?
And trot. So it's for you to feel, as long as he goes forward into the trot, into the walk, sorry, you can give him a couple of strides of walk. If you feel him jamming, then he's trot again. Yeah, good, that's good. And if you do that, the better the transition, the easier it will be to, for you to stay in the trot and acquire the trot. And again. Trot. And just try to keep the trot a little smaller. Don't go for like a really big kind of medium trot. Just a little shorter stride, that's it. Don't try to be wow. Transition, the easier it will be to, for you to stay in the trot and acquire the trot. And again. Trot. And just try to keep the trot a little smaller. Don't go for like a really big kind of medium trot. Just a little shorter stride, that's it. Don't try to be wow. Just it, that's it.
Even I shout
so
to get that outside the leg
nearer
the door.
Trot, you go the other way.
You get your little fingers up.
Yeah.
But she thinks perhaps even I shout if I get that outside the leg nearer the door.
Trots, you go the other way.
You've got your little fingers up. Well, we bought two bags, so I've eaten three at home.
On the circle, first thing you really need to do is start green and turning the front, yeah? So you actually stay on your circle. And you get more connected in the canter, a bit more active. So keep turning the front. Good.
Well, we bought two bags, so I've eaten three at home.
On the circle, first thing you really need to do is start green and turning the front, yeah? So you actually stay on your circle. And you get more connected in the canter, a bit more active. So keep turning the front. Good. A little bit more.